This week in the Missouri Senate, we review a couple of different measures aimed at improving the economic climate in our state.
Senate Bill number 182.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Senate Bill 182 was pre-filed in December of last year, heard by the Missouri Senate Economic Development Committee on February 5th, sent to the Missouri House of Representatives on February 28th, sent to the executive branch on May 17th, signed by the governor on June 11th, and became law on August 28th. Senator Mike Steerpoy of Lee's Summit is the sponsor. He says Senate Bill 182 is generally known as the Border War Bill.
Kansas agrees. The four counties around Kansas City, on the Missouri side, it's Cass, Jackson, Clay, and Platt. On Kansas side, it's Johnson County, Wyandotte County, Douglas, and Miami counties. If both states agree, economic incentives would not be added to lure companies from one side of the state line to the other.
He adds this is not the first time for this proposal to see time on the Missouri Senate floor.
Earlier, a few years ago, this bill was originally passed. Kansas did not agree to it, but it was passed by the senator from the 7th and the former senator from the 17th, so we're just continuing that work and extending the date.
Now that Kansas officials have agreed to abide by the rules contained in Senate Bill 182, the new law will sunset on August 28, 2025.
Senate Bill 7, that bill is about venue and joinder.
For some Missouri senators, part of a better economic picture for the Show Me State includes making changes to the way Missouri's courts and judges operate. For those lawmakers, tort reform has been a major issue ever since 2010, when some of the reforms made in 2005 were started to be worked around or overturned by judges. This year, Senate Bill 7 was introduced and subsequently passed. But for those Missouri senators either opposed to or skeptical of this measure, changing joinder and venue rules went beyond the limit they wished to impose. Senator Carla May of St. Louis says revamping the way class action lawsuits are conducted in Missouri may go a bit far.
It says, shall not be joined together, regardless of whether the claims arise out of the same transaction, occurrence, or a series of transactions or occurrences with a common question of law. What does all of that mean? Basically, it's saying that if we both had problems with this product and we both live in the state of Missouri, they're saying that we can't come together in a class action suit against that giant corporation. So they want each of us to fight individually against the corporation.
In the end, lawmakers were able to reach a conclusion, and Senate Bill 7 took effect on August 28th. And remember, you can follow these and other issues facing the Missouri Senate by visiting our website, senate.mo.gov. Reporting from the state capitol, I'm Dean Morgan.